If your basement's a little damp, this might help, but I got something that's better to help, because this time of year you start to notice the toll winter took on our houses, right? Got problems with the basement, floors are falling down. I know who to call. Mike and Gail. Mike and Gail Rusk, I see you guys on TV all the time talking about this, and a lot of basements need a whole lot more than a little container there to take the dampness away, don't they?
They do, yes, yeah. Especially after the warm winter that we've had, the warm, wet winter that we've had.
How about that big rain we had the other day?
Still keeps coming.
We had a giant rain, and people in my neighborhood who never had wet basements got wet basements.
That's right, yeah. The ground has just stayed saturated. So when we get all this rain, and because the ground hasn't had a chance to dry up, you know, there's nowhere for the water to go, so it just keeps getting saturated, and eventually that water ends up in the basement. Absolutely.
Yeah, so sometimes it can come through the basement, but sometimes it can push a wall in also, can it?
That's right. Yeah, and one of the things I wanted to make sure that homeowners out there understood about Ohio basement systems is that, you know, we have expertise in a lot of different types of problems. And so lots of times we get called out to a home because there's water, and we find out that it's due to maybe some structural concern. Or we get out there because of a structural concern, like a crack in a wall or something like that, and also find a water problem. So our technicians have the ability to get out there and diagnose anything that might
There's
be going on.
There's an evil site right there.
Yeah, that's a basement that's sunk. The corner of that foundation has literally sunk down about an inch or so. And so you get this kind of stair-stepping crack going from the top, you know, out to the left on the bottom there.
And Gail, like if somebody wants to sell their house, you've been in real estate, and somebody goes down to the basement, they see that. How much money does that knock off a house? A ton, doesn't it?
Yes, yes.
I mean, you don't even want it.
No, you want to definitely call us, have us come out, give an inspection. You know, the realtors, the homeowners, the buyers, the sellers, they get a lot of anxiety over it. So we'll get out there, we'll give them a free inspection, an estimate, and have that looked at, because you don't want to ruin that sale.
No, indeed. Hey, Mike, when you were talking about the footer sunk, or
that's right.
So are you trying to raise that footer, or are you just trying to fill that gap and stop water from coming through?
That's right. We have two different types of sinking problems. One would be the foundation wall, which would be the footer. So the footer would sink and the wall would sink with it. Mm-hmm. The other one would be slabs of concrete, like driveways, patios. They also sink. It's all due to unstable soil. Soil gets wet, and you can smush it down, or it dries out, which means you get these air gaps in there. Exactly. Mm-hmm. So unstable soil causes these things to sink. And unstable soil also causes water to be able to make its way into the basement. Here's a photo of a concrete driveway that you can see is literally sunk about 2-3 inches. And we have a special product that we can put down
underneath
there.
This is new technology,
too. It is.
Yeah, poly level.
It's a foam. And so we can put it in, and the foam will raise that concrete back up again. And as you can see, raises it right back up to where it should have been all along. And we can put that foam in through an opening that's only as big as about a dime.
So you're not tearing the house up or the
driveway? No, not at all. And you can walk on it, drive on it within 15 minutes to a half hour after it's done.
You know, I can relate to this too. I've got a stone patio, and over the years, it starts to sink next to the house a little bit. So when it rains, the rain doesn't go away from the house. Where does it go?
Right, exactly. It runs toward the house and can create other problems. Mm-hmm. So that's again one of the reasons why I did want to make sure that homeowners understood that you really have to be an expert in a lot of different things in order to make the right diagnosis on a foundation.
Because it could be a myriad of problems.
That's right. Here's a wet basement, you know, where you can see the paint's peeling off and you can see the mold starting to grow at the bottom.
That's why she wears the boots.
That's right. That's right. This is a basement where you would need boots. This is an after photo. So this is, not only have we been able to dry this basement up, but we've been able to put some panels on it to make it look nice and bright and clean. So when you asked about real estate a minute ago, you can imagine somebody walking in this basement saying, oh, this is great.
I'll take it.
This adds to the value of the
home. I won't
take
this one.
No, this is a crawl space. And same thing, you get a lot of dampness and moisture in these crawl spaces, and it creates all kinds of problems with rotting wood or the insulation beginning to rot and fall out the bottom. And so we come in, and you can see the difference here. We insulate it. We line it. We put in some equipment that helps to take the water out. Yeah. This equipment here will take 100 pints of water out every single day out of the air.
So a job like the last two jobs we saw there where we had mold, we had water and that sort of thing, would it require excavation also?
It could. It just depends. If it's something that is happening from the outside and we can access the outside, then we can open it up from the outside. We do both. Yep. We do outside work. We do inside work. We do a combination of the two. What we like to do is make an assessment of what we think is going to solve the problem in the most economical and long-term way.
So that's a big point. Don't be scared to call.
That's
right. Some people think, you know, it's like, oh, no, what am I getting myself into? But you know, you come in, like the doctor, you know, you say, well, You want to keep that leg or lose it.
That's right. And even if you're not looking to take action right away, at least you're going to know what the cause is, you're going to know what your options are, and you're going to know what the cost is going to be.
Excellent. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You guys are lovely.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Great.
Sure. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.